Hello and welcome to SternFX. My name is Eran, and in this tutorial, I'll show you how to improve the performance of After Effects. Now, according to Adobe, the number one request when it comes to After Effects is how to make it faster and more efficient. Over the last few years, Adobe has put a lot of effort in these areas, and I figure out it's time for me to give my two pence and show you what you can do to make After Effects work faster and smoother. So in the first episode of this series, I'll talk about performance. Now make sure to subscribe to the channel so you won't miss the upcoming videos where I'm going to discuss other topics such as previews, quality, multi-frame rendering, draft 3D, proxies, and effects. But this is still to come. This time, it's all about the gear. So let's begin. So before you start using After Effects, the first thing I recommend is to make sure that you've installed the current version. Adobe keeps pushing updates, bug fixes, and of course, new features all the time. So it is a good practice to always check that you have the latest version, which you can do by going to the Help menu and then select Updates. This will launch Creative Cloud, and over here, you can click Check for Updates. See if there's anything new and consider updating to the current version. Now, notice that you can also manage other versions of any application, including, of course, After Effects. And over here, you can choose to roll back if there's a need. Second, make sure that you've installed the latest versions of drivers and plugins, especially video card drivers. To download updates for drivers and plugins, you need to go to the provider's website. Now, I recommend that you will spend a moment or two and read the fine print to verify that this is the correct version for you. We all know that After Effects is a very hungry RAM application, so make sure that you have enough of it. The optimum performance is achieved with at least 2 gigs of RAM per processor core. So you'll need to do the math depending on your system configuration, but generally speaking, you'll need at least 16 gigs of RAM and probably 32 or even 64 gigs if you want to work with 4K footage. The more you have, the better and faster After Effects performs. Another important thing is to quit applications that are not necessary for your work. Web browsers such as Google Chrome are very demanding apps. So if you don't need to surf the web while you are working, quit it or maybe consider an alternative browser such as Safari, Firefox, or Edge if you are working on Windows. Be aware that some Adobe apps can share a memory pool, and you don't need to manage them manually. Now you can see these apps in the Memory and Performance Preferences tab inside After Effects and also monitor and change the memory usage details. Again, these are not all the Adobe applications, so if you're using, for example, Illustrator or Bridge, you'll need to stop or pause resource-intensive operations over there. Remember that After Effects always point to external files. Unlike Photoshop, Illustrator, or InDesign, it doesn't embed them in the project, so you will need to keep the source footage files on a fast local disk drive. If your source footage files are on a slow disk drive across a slow network connection, then the performance will be poor. Ideally, use a separate fast local disk drives for your source footage files and your rendered output. Because of their speed, SSD drives work well for this function. Now, if you have a fast local disk, you can enable caching frames to disk for previews. This will appear as a blue bar in the timeline and can help speed up previews when working with the same files, even from different projects. You'll get the most out of this feature if you'll assign the path to a separate fast drive, which is a different drive from your system drive. Now, I personally don't use this feature because I found out that RAM works better for my needs. So this is totally up to you, but this feature can really speed your previews dramatically if you have the right setup. So it's worth testing it out. Now, by far the best way to improve performance overall is to plan ahead. Run early tests for your workflow and output pipeline and confirm that what you are delivering is what your client actually wants and expects. I've included a link to a great article by Adobe in the description below about planning your work. It is a long read, but it goes through many important decisions such as acquiring and preparing footage, project settings, storage options, cross-platform project considerations, and much more. So I highly recommend that you read it before you start your work. Now, if you did all of these things and you are still frustrated from After Effects performance, join me for the next part where I'll talk about preview options and how to get the most out of them. But this is it for now. I hope this information was useful, and if so, please like and subscribe. I want to thank you for watching, and I will see you again next time.